Welcome to the Lenten Daily Devotion. Thank you for joining us. All of us at the Music Ministry are always glad to have an opportunity to connect with you outside of our usual worship. It is great to be part of this devotion where we offer the important and valuable messages from our hymns as a guidance during this meaningful season of Lent. Let us pray the collect for the second Sunday of Lent. O God, whose glory it is always to have mercy, be gracious to all who have gone astray from your ways, and bring them again with penitent hearts and steadfast faith to embrace and hold fast the unchangeable truth to your word. Jesus Christ, your Son, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Today's hymn is hymn 379, God is Love, verse 2 and 3. The hymn is written by Timothy Rees, who was a bishop of Llandaff in Wales in early 20th century. This text was found after his death in 1939. They found 7 hymns in total, and 2 of them were used in his funeral, and this hymn was one of them. The verse 2 writes, God is love, and love enfolds us. All the world in one embrace, with unfailing grasp God holds us, every child of every race. And when human hearts are breaking on the sorrow's iron rod, then we find that self-same aching deep within the heart of God. It is greatly comforting image. God is love, and that every God, and that very God enfolds us and embrace all of us. I love how the second verse begins with this complete trust in the love of God, but then also it does not deny that we face challenges and pain in our daily lives. He says, when human hearts are breaking under the sorrow's iron rod, there is no denying that it happens to all of us. We all have those times when challenges we face are solid and so impossible to bend or unbreakable. He continues to write that God also feels that in his heart with us. I think it is worthy to note that during his time as the bishop, Timothy Rees struggled with massive economical depression in his diocese. He was known to be very close to people in the working class and had to watch great struggle that came with massive unemployment of the mining industry during his time. This reflection on sharing the burden on human level looks to have inspired Bishop Rees to write about how God not only shares our pain and sorrow, but also it resonates in God. The hymn tune for hymn 379 is called Abbot's Lee, written by Cyril Vincent Taylor around 1940s during the World War II, and we see over and over great arts being created in time of struggle. We see the blessing of creativity shining through in the darkest times in both our hymn and the music. This is symbolic to how God's love can shine through in contemplative time, such as Lent. On the third verse, we hear God's eternal loving kindness guides us through our earthly strife. God's love shines through our sin, our strife many times caused by our own faults, or through worldly challenges. We often read about God's love in the Bible, especially during the season of Lent. We hear John chapter 3, verse 14 through 21 in one of our lectionary readings during Lent, where it says, "For God so loved the world, he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but have eternal life." This gospel reading is one of the more consistent scripture readings that appear during Lent, and it has inspired many composers to write beautiful anthems based on it. Going back to the verse 2 of hymn 379 on how God shares our pain, there is no better example than this. God sent his only Son, and this is how God showed us that he not only loves us, but he loves us so much that he shared the earthly pain with us. How do we thank him? How do we respond to this love? Music is one way to respond. Singing hymns, therefore praying twice, like St. Augustine said, is one way to respond. In modern times, music is often associated with entertainment. Often the value of the music solely depends on how popular or how much people enjoy it, but over and over and time after time, we find music that are everlasting and timeless. Johann Sebastian Bach was never considered to be the best composer during his time. In fact, his music was considered too difficult, and they weren't used for decades, and now it is recognized as one of the most emotionally charged and spiritually moving music we inherited. We hope these Lenten devotions invite ourselves into these hymns and use them to pray rather than merely pretty music that we have around us. We will be blessed by learning more about these hymns as a beautiful legacy we receive from Christians from previous generations and generations who experienced hardships and who experienced God's love just as we have. Through these hymns, we're not only praying with each other, but with the Bishop Rees, who wrote this text, and Cyril Vincent Taylor, who wrote the music, and those who sang these hymns, many before us and around us, all over the country and world. People from different generations and regions feel and experience God's love translated through this hymn. During this Lent, I invite you all to reflect on that God's love, and in different ways, God's love is translated into your life. As we listen to this hymn, let us offer thanks to God for this wonderful love that we undeservingly and yet fully receive.